Decimal numbers are just fractions where the denominator is a power of 10. So we have tenths, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths, and so on. Each position is worth a certain fraction of a whole, just like each position to the left of the decimal point is worth a multiple of a whole. The 9 in this number is worth 9 times 10, or 90. In exactly the same way, the 2 is worth 2 divided by 10, or 2 tenths. The 4 is worth 4 divided by 1,000, or 4 thousandths. We tend to say decimal numbers by simply reading off the digits. 91.2548. But if we do want to refer to a specific digit, we use its place value, which is just the name of a fraction. 5 hundredths, round off to the nearest thousandth, and so on. Represent decimal fractions using anything you can easily divide into 10, 100, 1,000. Square grids work well. And if you have physical objects that can be held and manipulated, all the better. Do you have some square blocks that could be arranged into squares or built up into solid blocks? Here's how to do it. 0.4. Incidentally, I encourage you to always write that leading zero so that the decimal point doesn't get lost when you read it back later. Draw a fraction as usual. 0.4 is just 4 tenths. Then if I need hundredths, I can divide up my fraction into hundredths like this, and I have 40 hundredths, 0.40. In fact, we can use this model to convert a decimal fraction into a common fraction. For example, suppose I have 0.16. Well, it's got two decimal digits, so I'm going to need hundredths. Draw a square grid with 100 squares, 10 by 10. Shade 16 squares, 16 hundredths. So write it as a common fraction, 16 over 100. Okay, now simplify the fraction if possible. Do 16 and 100 have any common factors? Yes, 4. Divide both top and bottom by 4 to get 4 25ths. This is 0.16 as a common fraction in simplest form. What about going the other way? How do I convert a common fraction into a decimal number? Just look for an equivalent fraction with a denominator that's a power of 10. 3/5. Well, 5 goes into 10 twice, so use tenths. 3 times 2 is 6. 6/10, which is 0.6. 7/20. Well, I can't use 10 because I'd have to have half of 7 on the top, and 2 doesn't go evenly into 7. So try 100 instead. 20 times 5 is 100. 7 times 5 is 35. 35 hundredths, which is 0.35. 3/8. 10 won't work. 8 doesn't go into 10. 100 won't work. 8 doesn't divide 100 either. I have to go all the way to 1,000. You may want a calculator here. 8 goes into 1,000 125 times. So I have 3 times 125, which is 375. 0.375. Okay, now a hard one. 2/11. Have a think about it. What can I use on the denominator? 11 won't go into 10. What about 100? 1,000? In fact, there's no power of 10 that I can put on the denominator of this fraction. It's simply impossible. Does that mean I can't write 2/11 as a decimal? Well, kind of. Let's try working this out a different way. Remember, the fraction line, the vinculum, just means divide. Do you know the written algorithm for dividing whole numbers without a calculator? We're going to extend that into decimals. It works like this. 2 divided by 11. How many times does 11 go into 2? It doesn't. 0 remained a 2. Well, we could write 2 as 2.0, putting a decimal point in our answer as well, and keep going from there. Carry the remainder 2. 11 to 20 goes once, remainder 9. Write another 0 and keep going. 11 into 90, 11 eighths are 88, leaving 2 left over. Carry the remainder. 11 into 20 goes once, remainder 9. 11 into 90 goes 8 times, remainder 2. 11 into 20 goes... Can you see the pattern developing here? What's happening? We're getting the same digits repeating again and again and again. It's never going to stop, is it? We call this a recurring decimal. The pattern repeats forever. We write it like this, with a bar over the repeating pattern. Be careful with these. You cannot write this number accurately as a decimal without including the recursion symbol, the bar, or sometimes just a dot if it's only a single digit that repeats. You can round it off, but you must remember that that would then be only an approximation. It won't be exactly equal to the fraction. As a teacher, there are some common fraction decimal equivalents that you should just know by heart. Draw yourself up a table like this, halves, thirds, quarters and so on, all the way to tenths. Now go back and write next to each one its decimal equivalent. Then learn the table. No, I mean it. You really should know these. You will need them in the classroom and you don't want to be reaching for a calculator every time. Finally, calculating with decimals. Just extend the written algorithms you already know for whole numbers, like I did earlier with that decimal division. Work out the meaning by remembering that they're really just another way of writing fractions. That's all there is to it. But I will warn you to be careful with multiplication. The number of decimal places in your answer may not be what you expect. Look carefully at your answer in the context of the original question to make sure that your answer makes sense.